now standing near the heel stone, the tall stone near the road, opposite marker number 6. It leans towards the circle, almost pointing at it. The heel stone's a sus that hasn't been shaped by hammering with mauls, which is why it's an irregular shape. It marks the end of the avenue, the procession route used in the long-ago ceremonies that may have taken place here. You can't see the avenue very well now, but if you look at the base of the heel stone, you'll see a slight ridge in the ground on either side. Those are the borders of the avenue. The avenue continued across the road and over the field beyond. Then it turned right and went up the hill to your right, over the hill between the trees and down to the banks of the River Avon near Amesbury.
But imagine how even more impressive the stones would have been if you were taking part in a procession approaching Stonehenge by the avenue. The way the sarsens were shaped gives an optical illusion of greater height, and the circle would have towered above you as you climbed up the hill. Perhaps it was, after all, simply a symbol of power. Maybe that was the real power and significance of Stonehenge. The power it had over the daily lives of the people, and as a symbol of existing authority, which lasted for